All right, Mazzy. Julianne Moore is gonna be here in like 2 seconds and I need help with my interview questions. Will you help me? Okay. Yeah. Just need you to put this on, okay? A lot of your movies deal with dissatisfaction with suburban life and being disillusioned with the conventions of the American dream. How does that play into your parenting? So just FYI, it's a little bit crazy around here because it's back to school week. It was the first day of school for my kids. I didn't have a chance to really tell Mazzy who you are. Yeah. Usually I give her like, you know, a little brief bio, I show her some pictures, you know, tell her a little bit.
Is this the green room?
Yeah. Do you mind if I have a seat?
I were playing store.
Oh, I love store. How much is this drawing?
$10 You can't buy it.
It's, you can't buy it?
No. Do you want a goldfish?
Oh, thank you so much. I would love a goldfish, thank you.
Okay, so your mom told me I should give you some background. Sometimes I'm in movies, but I also write books. My books are for kids.
Well, I like to say I'm 5'5", but I think I'm actually 5'4½".
Hi, everyone. Today we're talking to somebody that everybody knows, and that is Academy Award nominated actress and children's author, Julianne Moore. Give her a warm welcome, Mazzy. Nice to see you too.
We met in the green room, right?
I know.
Yeah, and I saw
How did
your
that
picture.
Go?
Oh, well, right? This is not for sale.
So do you want to tell me what the inspiration for this book is?
The inspiration is my own mother, who's from Scotland and came to the United States when she was 10 years old. And so, and I was born when she was very young. So she really had only been in the country for 10 years when I was born. So she was still very much a Scottish person and didn't even,
So did it ever embarrass you having a mom from a different culture?
It didn't embarrass me. Kids would say like, you know, why does your mom talk funny?
Right.
Or, you know, silly things like, you know, we have mince pies at the holidays and nobody in the United States had those. In those days. I think they do now.
It's interesting because your first book, Freckle-Faced Strawberry, I feel like it also kind of deals with a kid who feels like an outsider.
Sure, yeah.
I think everybody feels like an outsider sometimes.
Freckle-Faced Strawberry, my son was 7 and it's sort of that time when they start noticing the physicality. And that was around the same time that I was starting like to hate my friends.
Right. So do you think like with the internet and things like that, I always wonder, like obviously kids are gonna get exposed to a lot of things quicker. It also helps kids not feel like so alone.
I think actually books are better for that. Because I think the internet is can be a very I think you feel sort of isolated. But I think in books you can have a kind of collective sense. Often what is most personal is most universal. So a kid can have a feeling like, hey, how'd they know that about me? And then you go, well, everybody feels that way.
Wait, hang on.
Hello? No, I can't talk right now. I'm doing an interview. No, I'll call you back. Okay, go back, bye. I am so sorry. I told him not to call me.
So today we're gonna make butterflies.
Oh, thank goodness.
So we're gonna try and make one of these. So,
okay, good luck, everybody.
You take one big piece of paper. We cut it into squares already.
Okay.
Let's see.
Mommy,
wait a minute. Yeah?
I want pink.
Yeah. You want a pink pipe cleaner?
Yeah.
We'll make sure you get that pink
Mazzy,
one.
I'm going to go with a greeny kind. What do you think?
Oh, that one.
Let me see. That's very nice. Thank you very much. I made a covered wagon once.
Oh, okay.
For school. For a school project.
This is your kid's project. Yes. And did you help her a lot with it? Like what?
Did I help her? We did it together, but I did. I'm, you know, ashamed to admit, I said, all right, let's Google how to make a covered wagon.
So we just had to do like an About Me book for her first day.
Right.
And I probably did a little bit more of it than I was supposed to.
Look, I have now, what do I do?
You're fast.
I'm really fast at craft.
So I'm curious, what were you filming at the times when you were pregnant?
Yes. For my son, I was pregnant in The Big Lebowski. My daughter, it was on Far From Heaven, and
can
I was
I
super pregnant on that. I didn't know if this was the head and these were the feet. You think these are the antenna?
I'm not sure.
Know. I don't know.
I missed that part of it.
I didn't know which way was up. You like mine?
Mm-hmm.
You want it?
That's
no.
Pretty.
No.
Oh, I thought it made the
butterfly. No.
To explain the birds and bees at your house?
Me. I like to.
Yeah, I think it's fun.
And the one piece of advice that I got too from someone was you don't have to give them more information than they've asked for. So when a child that's, you know, Mazzy's age says, where do babies come from? You can just say, they grow in mommy's tummy. How old were your kids when they realized you were famous?
I don't really know, except I do remember my son, we were in a mall, and I was on the cover of a magazine, and he said, Mommy, Mommy, look, there's Julianne Moore on the magazine.
Of all the characters that you've played, who would you trust the most to watch your kids?
Well, my characters are crazy. I don't think I trust any of them.
Now, did either of your kids have a blankie or comfort item when they were little?
No, they didn't, but they both nursed a really long time. I nursed my son for a year, and I nursed my daughter for 16 months. Uh-huh. And I think that was their kind of comfort thing,
right.
So it never became about
so
an
your
object.
Boobs were there.
It was my boobs, that's right.